All right. Welcome back to the channel, guys. I'm Hank Strange, and we're at the 2019 SHOT Show. We're on the convention floor, and we're actually in the Franklin Armory booth. And we're talking to Jay. Jay's the owner of Franklin Armory. So thanks for getting on here with us. I know there's a couple things going on, some little SHOT Show drama, kerfuffle going down with you guys.
Yeah.
What exactly happened? I think something happened with you and the in-range TV guys.
So I instructed my staff that if Carl or Ian show up, that they need to talk to me before any interview is to be conducted. And the reason is that they did something that I didn't think was quite ethical last year. When what happened was they were doing an interview with Sun. They put the lid on the lens and continued on as if the interview was over, still asking questions, but they were trying to trip him up into some kind of statement off recorded, but they were recording anyways. So if you happen to go back and look at their video, you'll see that it closes up and then they keep talking.
Okay, so, and that's still published?
That's still published. And to me, that's some shady stuff right there. So I had a problem with that, and I just wanted to have a one-on-one with them to say, hey, this is what it is, and you'll talk to me, and I'll be your point of contact on that, and that's got to stop. That can't happen.
Okay. Yeah, I see where you're going with that. I think that, you know, the way that this show works, like we're two sides of the same coin pretty much. You know, some of us are in media. You guys are manufacturing things. You talk to people. You have to get their permission. You don't necessarily want to trip people up and stuff like that or make their life more difficult, although there's nothing wrong with asking tough questions, right?
Right. I have no problem with the tough questions. I mean, we've answered a lot of them. Last year we had a lot of guys, you know, there was a big pile-on going on,
right,
and they thought it was funny to be part of the in-crowd of make fun of Franklin Armory, blah, 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 over this product right here, incidentally. We just happened to line up
Reformation.
Here with Reformation. And I saw your video. Very well done.
Okay, thank you.
You know, ring and steal 100 yards, no problem.
Yeah.
You know, the guys that say that it's doesn't have value, they're missing the point. It transfers on a 4473. No weight, no trust, no having to, you know, have a problem if you go out of town and your wife's with the, you know, the SBR. This is not an SBR.
Right.
Transfers like anything else.
Yeah.
In any case.
Yeah. So the thing I think about that is that, you know, you guys made something. Instead, a lot of people for the last couple of years, as you know, have just been making AR-15s or whatever's hot and what's selling. I think you guys are trying to add options. Maybe it's not the right thing for everyone.
Right, I get it.
Yeah. So, you know, it's the kind of thing in the gun community. People like to pile on and beat someone up. You would think that maybe we're a little bit different with each other, but that doesn't exactly always happen. I think you guys knew you were getting into something controversial, right?
Well, the funny thing is, we didn't hype it up. All we did was put out a press release of, this is what we're doing. And what ended up happening was everybody went crazy over, oh my gosh, what is it? And then when they found out, they felt like, you know, maybe the air was taken out of their sails because they didn't understand how it works. I mean, the damage that can do with it, first of all, it doesn't even, for the first 15 yards, it's still straight and true. Mm-hmm. It's 3.5 inches at 100 yards. Mm-hmm. Fantastic, I mean, for what that is for CQB.
Right.
And you know, the damage from that, it has an initial wound cavity that's much greater, temporary wound cavity, than you would have with traditional ammo because it's closer. Regular hollow point projectile would go through, start to expand several inches in. This just hits, and it's open right away.
Okay, yeah.
But in any case, we knew that might be part of the deal, that there would be a little whatever. Yeah. So
I don't know personally. I've met Ian and stuff like that. I don't know the in-range guys. I don't feel like they're bad guys or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's probably just the nature of the whole thing that the folks out there get, you know, they get excited by some stuff and they like to pile on. So I don't know if they necessarily meant something. And I also know you guys. I don't think you guys are bad either. I think one of the things that happens in our community where we're not really working with each other is that we don't sit down and like talk to each other and realize that we're human beings and try to get along.
But here's what happened. So they came into our booth and my staff was starting to inform, hey, we can't do a recording. And Carl blew up. I wasn't there. I didn't see it, but I quizzed
everybody. So why did they wanted to do a recording? Because you didn't want them to record at all? Or did you want to talk to them or something?
I wanted to talk to them. I wasn't here at the time because they didn't exactly make an appointment.
Okay.
Basically, they came in. They were being informed that they would not be able to do a recording. Ryan didn't even get to the chance of saying, until you talked to Jay. And basically, Carl blew up. And then it ended up that another one of our booth personnel said, you are leaving the booth now, which okay. they did. They went and talked for a little bit. And to be honest with you, Ian was polite enough to come back and apologize to my guys. He didn't mean for it to go down that
okay.
way.
Oh, I'm glad. That's what I wanted to ask you, man. I would hope that you guys would actually be able to sit down and talk about this. And
but check this out. When I got word of it, I talked to everybody here, got a lowdown on what happened. We called them back and said, mm-hmm. we need to talk, and then you could do an interview. Mm-hmm. Well, it's better ratings for them to mm-hmm. just try and dump on us than it is to come back and be a man and do that.
Oh. Well, you know? I hope that's not true. I hope they do actually come back and talk to you guys and get some info. That's what I hope,
they
honestly.
They told me today that they wouldn't. In fact,
oh, okay. That's too
when
bad.
I posted on their YouTube last night, I said, hey, this is what happened. Mm-hmm. They're welcome to give us a call. So they got a phone message. Mm-hmm. They got a post on YouTube. Mm-hmm. And they got an opportunity when Sun, our marketing director, sent him a Facebook instant message. Crickets. I happened to run into him in the hall over here. And
you ran into who? Ian?
Carl and Ian.
Okay.
Ran into both of them. And I had a frank discussion with them about where they can go from here. Mm-hmm. And honestly, if they want to come back, we could sit and talk.
Yeah. I would hope would do that. I mean, I think a lot of people... I don't think most people look at those guys for the controversy. I think they're trying to get some information. I would hope they come back. I know sometimes this gets controversial. It happens with me. Like, I happen
no.
to this year. Yes, it does, Jay. It does. I happen to be asking folks when I talk to them, if I do a video, right, where they're at with the Second Amendment. And I know that there's people that don't like some of the answers. Maybe it's a little embarrassing to the companies. I've had a company tell me that they don't get into politics. But that doesn't mean I want to fight with those companies or get anything off the controversy. This is just really important. And we're kind of like on an island surrounded by everyone else, mm-hmm. and we're going to lose the Second Amendment. I think if we think it's important...
If it keeps going this way,
yeah,
we will, unfortunately.
Yeah. But we need each other.
Yes.
Right? All of us. Mm-hmm. We need you guys as the manufacturers, us as the content creators. We need the audience out there. We all need... I know we can't all get along. There's people that I just don't like.
I hear you.
Right? But we need to try to get along as much as we can. So I hope that somewhere along the way, like, you know, the controversy stuff dies down, and they actually think, hey, let's go talk to these guys and find out what this thing is and put the info out
there.
Well,
I'm really glad that you came by, because really their narrative is that we kicked them out of the booth for no reason,
okay.
and that we didn't try to reach out to them. We've done so in multiple ways to make that happen,
okay.
and they prefer to stir up the
okay.
I don't want to use a bad word, but stir it up instead mm-hmm. of coming back and reconciling.
Okay. So right now, do you feel like they still need to talk to you, or if you're not here and they come back by the booth and they want to have a look, because you have something new, right?
I have dictated to them that if they want to come back, they'll be talking to me and no one else.
Oh, okay. I understand that, and I think you're well within
technical.
Your rights for that.
They're okay. very. Ian's a smart guy. They're mm-hmm. very technical. And when it comes down to technical questions like that, I'm probably
okay.
the most...
Understood, yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's absolutely within your rights. So I want to get that answer from you on the Second Amendment. And also, what's the new thing that you guys are releasing?
So we'll go ahead and bring that in.
Yeah.
So this is Providence. Now, it was designed essentially for overseas markets, for European Union.
Okay.
Basically, what we did was we looked at the definition of semi-automatic. Mm-hmm. And definition of semi-automatic would be using gas from the ignition of the round to function the action.
Okay.
This does not. What it does is, as you use your finger to pull it back, you can see that it gets to a certain point, and then it'll snap forward. As it does,
okay.
it'll scoop a round off the magazine and chamber it.
Okay.
And when it does that, you got a locking rotating bolt that will go into battery. And as the locking rotating bolt goes into battery, there's a carrier that'll be coming in behind it.
Mm-hmm.
And then there'll be a fixed firing pin.
Okay.
So very similar to an AR except for the fixed firing pin
okay.
part. When that fixed firing pin hits the primer, it'll ignite the round, go downrange, and then nothing happens until next time when you pull the trigger back again, it'll extract, eject,
okay.
and then
so
go through the same process.
So you're doing the manual work.
Exactly. We
okay.
call it digital action.
Digital action.
And there's nothing electronic about it.
Digital. Okay. Has the ATF, because you said you did this for overseas, Does that same definition overseas apply here? And has the ATF taken a look at this yet?
Two questions there. So to answer those differently, the each location is different. Looks like Canada, that's a shoo-in. Looks like Australia will make some changes. And then EU, we believe that it would be good to go just as it is. Now, as far as the ATF, we rushed this to get this to the show. I'm not going to lie, right?
Is this the prototype, the only one out there?
These two. Yeah, there's another one over there.
Two. Okay.
The only ones out there. So we created these just for the show, got them out here. They're ready to roll. But we're going to be doing a lot of testing. Hopefully by April, we'll be able to draw a line in the sand. And the final production unit might look different. We might have a longer barrel, shorter barrel, different stock, whatever.
It's definitely 9mm.
More than likely 9mm. In the U.S. market, that would be the most appropriate. Other locations, Australia, we might start off with 22. Different locations.
380, because some people don't allow 9mm.
You know, 380 was brought up for south of the border. But 10mm would be ideal for pig hunting. 45 would be fantastic as well for suppressed applications.
I think that's cool. I don't, like everything else, I don't think it's for everyone.
Right.
I think there's people, like you said, overseas that will give them access to freedom. Freedom is the ability to defend yourself. You know, and then even here in America, there's some people right now that, that could use that. I think there's some other benefits to it.
If you can get the gun, then you become a gun voter.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, you start thinking about guns and rights and why you can't have other stuff.
Exactly.
Okay.
But if you don't have one, then you're uninitiated. You're not part of that voting block.
Right, exactly, exactly. Okay, and I heard that this is, like, good for suppressors and things like that.
Yeah, so the funny thing is that we've had a lot of domestic interest. Besides the states like New York and Connecticut, New Jersey and Massachusetts, where this will fit right in, looking at other areas of the country running suppressed, all you hear is this. There's no shuck. It's just that. And this is a lot quieter than your typical AR action and will be very effective for that for that platform. Because, again, you have that locking, rotating bolt that locks in place. No gas is coming back. Even in a AR that is running suppressed, you still have that temporary flow of gas.
Do you guys have an animation of that?
I'm sure Ryan does.
Somewhere. Okay. Yeah. Okay, very cool. Do you know... I think you said it maybe before when it's going to be available. Do you know what the price point's going to be? Anything
so,
like that?
We hope to have these on dealer shelves by October, God willing. Price point, we're shooting under $1,500.
Under $1,500. And then, you know, when I do videos with you guys, I get a lot of comments about the price point. So let's hit that. If folks out there, you know, have some issues with the price point, what's your explanation for why the price point?
I'm glad you asked the question there because... quite frankly, everything we do is 100% American-made materials, the labor to machine it, the machines, etc. 100% American-made, and it costs more than having to go overseas. I've had so many guys from Turkey, South Korea, China coming over here trying to sell us parts for ARs. Think about that. Your typical $399 AR. How much of that is actually made in America? Now, from company to company, that's going to vary. But what those people are doing is selling commodities. What we try to do is sell something that is asymmetrical, that is useful for a certain application. And that way we can make jobs here. We've got 30 people working in Nevada. I had the governor of Wyoming over at that side of the booth earlier today, and he brought his whole entourage. They would really love us to expand over there. With this product here, there could be thousands of these overseas that we're looking at based on the reports that the distributors that want to export it from here into there. And we're looking to make jobs here. Now, that's a heck of a lot better than importing stuff that made overseas, bringing it in.
Absolutely, I understand that. And then I'm sure there's development costs here, right?
Oh,
because
certainly.
You're making something that's brand new or newish, there's a lot of that goes into that. Prototypes, testing.
New machinery.
All the stuff with the ATF. I'm sure you're going to have to send a couple of these off to the ATF.
That was another question you had earlier. So these were rushed to get to the show. We didn't have a chance to make any announcement to ATF. So last week I sent Chief Earl Griffith an email. I said, sir, this will be coming out to you in the next... probably 30 days or so for him to evaluate. And so he knows it's coming. He emailed back saying they won't be here because of the shutdown. I actually invited him to come to the booth and take a look.
Oh, so the ATF's not here.
Yeah, wink,
they're probably here, but they're not here. I saw the FBI here, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, at least we got those guys. Okay, so before you go, I know you're busy, you got some meetings. On the question of the Second Amendment, okay, I'm going to give you like a soapbox to stand on as a company, mm-hmm. and either let people know or not, whatever, it's up to you. How do you feel about the Second Amendment, and what are you doing? What's the company doing? What are you personally doing mm-hmm. to fight or not fight for the Second Amendment? You know, what do you think about it?
So the Second Amendment is the linchpin of all the other rights. If you don't have a Second Amendment, guess what? Everything else could be washed away. Yes, we don't have a parliament like they do in some of these other countries where things can change overnight, but even so, they could change over weeks. And if you lose your right to the Second Amendment, you have no way of backing it up. Mm-hmm. Beyond that, it provides domestic security. I know countries like Finland, always worried about Russia rolling over their borders.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Every one of those folks rock and rolling with a militia, you know,
right.
deal.
Exactly.
There. So I think that's important for the United States. It was important back in World War II, wasn't it? Yamamoto said there would be a dude behind every blade of grass.
Yeah. Exactly.
So I think that's huge.
I'm it's also, a good deterrent.
Yeah. And I'm also a member of the California Rifle Pistol Association, where I serve on the board mm-hmm. and donate my time there. And I donate my funds as well to that organization. We sell something called the Drop-In Fix Mag, and a portion of every one of those sales goes to pay for donations to the foundation, which is earmarked for litigation in California specifically.
Okay.
Screwed up state, bunch of Democrats running that. Hate to get too political.
Right.
But, you know, and there are pro-gun Democrats, but they're few and far between.
Right, yeah.
The bottom line is that California's just destroyed.
It's got issues. I think a lot of you guys are originally California guys. Some
yes.
of the folks moved over to Nevada, right? I don't know if you're in California, Nevada.
I've got a house in both locations.
Okay. And I think that you're fighting in both places as well as the entire country, right?
Oh, yeah. And unfortunately, in Nevada, we have a new governor that's anti-gun.
Yes.
So what does that mean for SHOT Show?
I don't know. We might not be doing SHOT Show at all, or here at least.
Yeah, it might be in a new venue.
Yeah.
I would hate to see that happen. I love coming to Las Vegas for that mm-hmm. purpose, but if that's what comes, and so be it. We're looking, we spoke to the governor of Wyoming, we'll be talking to Utah and Idaho as well, mm-hmm. and we're going to consider our options for it, at least expansion. I mean, if we're making 20,000 of these next year, mm-hmm. where is that going to be made? Is it going to be made here or somewhere else?
Yeah.
That's kind of up to the political whims and
ultimately, that's why I think we can't avoid it. You know, I'm not saying that we should get into people's bedrooms and all that kind of stuff.
None of my
but
business.
At the end of the day, like you said, you know, we have the Second Amendment there to keep up this kind of government that we have running in America. I've lived in a lot of different places around the world. It's not perfect here, but I don't want to live anywhere else.
Me neither.
Know, because this is as close as you can get to it. We need to maintain that. We've lost some things, so mm-hmm. I don't think we can 100% avoid that, you know. And it's good to know that, you know, there's at least a few of the companies out there doing something about it. So.
Oh, most definitely. I mean, it's our obligation.
Absolutely. All right. Before I end, I just want to say, you know, I think you guys are good guys over here. The in-range guys are good guys. I hope that they could come back. Are you going to be here tomorrow?
I certainly
will. You're going to be here the rest of the day?
Yes.
Okay. So I would hope if they have a chance, they come back and at least let their audience have an opportunity to see what you guys are putting out, ask you some questions, even the tough ones, you know.
Yeah, you know what? And that's okay. I mean,
yeah.
I believe in the First Amendment just as much as the Second. If they want to have an opinion, that's fine. But don't do shady stuff.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Be
real. Absolutely. Okay. Thanks a lot, Jay. I appreciate it.
Pleasure.
Appreciate it.
Hank.
All right, guys. So I'll get you some closer details and stuff like that of this, but I just wanted to fill you in on that. So we're out of here. Peace.